So last week we talked about Qorn-Horn and his dashing escape from the Lusankia prison.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, by the way, that happened. So a little story about I thought I might have been going to prison this week and wasn't sure what had happened. So let's back up and kind of explain some things.
What?
Okay, so I'm not a lawbreaker, but what had happened was my wife and I, we went out to eat after church with some church people. That's another conversation because, like, all the churches take over Whataburger. Somebody walked in and was like, oh, it must be spirit night. And I'm like, actually, all the youth groups got out, but that's fine. Anyway, so we're leaving. We're going home. And my wife and I, two different cars. I'm driving the little black Nissan. My wife's driving the minivan because, you know, we're definitely a minivan family, right?
Oh, yeah.
And I see her, like, pull over all of a sudden. And I'm like, what just happened? And I call her, like, you okay? Whatever. She said, yeah, our daughter was screaming bloody murder. And turns out she spilled her drink and didn't know how to fix it. She's three. We'll give her a break. Anyway, we get home. And we let the dogs out because, remember, we got a puppy and it was getting kind of late. And we know that we needed to wear our dogs out really, really well. So we had our neighbor's dogs out there, live in a duplex. So two houses, both people have dogs and big fenced in backyard that can be connected. Anyway, we're out there playing
for success.
Yeah, that's right. Having a big old good party in the backyard. And all of a sudden we hear a ton of sirens. Like, sounds like the entire, like, county emergency response is going to go put out a fire or something. And I'm like, oh man, that's no good. There's a fire truck that goes around the block. And I'm like, huh, cool. And then a few minutes later, there's somebody, like, we have like a tall, like, 6 foot or so, 7 foot even, maybe, like, privacy fence. And I see somebody, like, trying to get my attention from the front yard, like, waving his arms over the fence, like, hey, come here. And I'm like, what is going on? There's somebody in my yard and there's lights. And now that I look through the fence, I see that those lights are flashing. There are flashing lights in my front yard. What is happening?
What?
And so I'm like, oh, okay, I'll be right up there. I'll go. Yeah. And so I go to the front door and the front door is cracked. And so I'm freaked out. Like, is there somebody in my house? What happened? And I open the door and there's two police officers there. They were very great, professional, all that. And they actually apologized. I said, hey, we knocked and the door opened. I'm sorry. I didn't do anything. And it's like, oh, no, it's cool. And they're like, so, yeah, we got a notification that there was an accident involving this town and country. And we were here. We were sent to check it out. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, accident? Like, no. So I guess what had happened.
Wild.
Is we have, like, a smart device that plugs into our phones, like, you know, computer, not our phone, our
not
car's
to be
computer.
With a dumb device.
Yeah, exactly. And it, like runs all the diagnostics. It keeps track of, like, our speed, our GPS, and, like, has, like, a Wi-Fi hotspot and all that. And apparently it registered an accident at some point. And then my wife kept driving home. And so they had no clue what was going on. I guess maybe they tried to call the car phone or whatever that's part of this, and no one answered. And so they, like, sent, like, the National Guard to make sure that somebody wasn't, like, hanging on for dear life. And I'm coming out in, like, my pajamas, like, we're good here. Everything's fine. How are you? You know, and trying to, like,
what
yeah.
in the world?
So our minivan called the cops on us and said that we were in an accident. And I was like, my wife might have stopped quickly, but I don't know what happened. It's fine. Everything's fine. And I was so embarrassed and, like, oh gosh. Yeah. So
you're a youth minister, everything's an accident.
Yeah. And the cops are not that uncommon, but this is my turn to be the one who was kind of doing something sketch. So yeah,
wow.
good times.
Wow. You gotta put a restraining bolt on that thing.
I'm gonna have to. Tell it, make sure it knows who the master is. Do we say that? I don't know.
You keep going with that metaphor. Rick.
Check its programming. I'll check its programming.
That's better.
Yeah.
There we
That's
go.
Good. Well, you know what? You're not gonna get a restraining bolt on this episode of Legends Look Back. It's gonna be off the hook, and I'm so excited to get into it. Episode's been a long time coming, requested by somebody a long time ago in the Discord, maybe Patreon. I don't know who it was or when it was. But we're finally getting to it. That is, we are finally going to have our very own Sith Lords draft here on Legends Look Back. This time, It's legendary. So, without further ado, Rick, let's start the show. Hello, everybody.
Uh-oh.
And I am... Let's try this again.
This is from last week whenever you weren't on the air. So let's do this again. Ta-da!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Legends Look Back, proudly part of the Eugenie Podcast Network. This is a Star Wars books podcast for people who are fiercely opinionated about which is better between the Care Bears and the Gummy Bears. Where we celebrate our rich EU history as well as dive into lesser-known Star Wars classics. I'm your host, Jared Mays, and I'm joined... once again, back in the saddle with the crew this week. Way to go, carrying on the show without me last week. Freddy C., how are you, man?
I'm doing all right, and I have an ode to the Gummy Bears. It goes like this. I'm never going to give you up. Never going to let you down.
Oh.
Never going to run around and desert you. That's my ode to the 100% the best Gummy Bears over Care Bears.
Nice.
Well, Freddy just Rickrolled us. I kind of... might have expected Rick to Rickroll us. Yeah. How are you, Rick Grace?
Oh, I am doing good. Hey, you know what that reminds me of? I was just thinking how great it would be if there was a montage of the trench run in A New Hope to Not Throwing Away My Shot from the Hamilton soundtrack. So
yes.
Wouldn't that be great? That would be great. I wish someone would make that for us.
Are you referencing how after last week's episode, Oz made the Les Mis mashup?
And he challenged me to work it in the show, and so I just like unabashedly bulldozed through that one. So
trying to host the show, I typically take whatever your responses are, and I field the curveballs, and then I toss them back around, and sling the ball back over to somebody else on the team. And both of you so far have thrown me the weirdest curveballs in the history of starting the show. You know who's going to throw me a totally normal ball? Emily Daybeck. That was weird. How are you, Emily?
Well, in the process of getting ready, warming up for tonight, for the draft, I was rolling out my back and somehow made it worse. So, welcome to 30.
30,
I'm,
for sure.
I'm here for it. I mean, glad it's a virtual athletic event.
That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
We keep talking.
No, you did throw a weird one. No, for sure. That one was also...
We keep talking about the draft. I'm just ready for the second edition or the final copy because I can't handle this draft business anymore.
Yeah, before the show started, Rick messaged me. He's like, man, what you got to tell me. What's the final episode of this? Final name of this episode?
I've been seeing draft all week.
You've had this in the calendar for 3 months as the Sith Lords draft. So what are we going to call the show?
Like the Sith Lords. Kept waiting for the other, word, but nothing came. Just draft.
The draft. That's right.
Yeah.
So it's something they do a lot over on the Living Force. They do a lot of the drafts. They just had one, this past week? The Scoundrels and Rogues and Spies and Tigers and Bears and Lions. What do they call those? The Scoundrels draft, right? The Rogues.
Mm-hmm.
And so Sith Lord is something they've done a while back. And as soon as they finished it, somebody said, I would love to have a Sith Lord's draft Legends Edition because there are a ton of Legends Sith Lords. I mean, I think canonically in canon, what are they like? Six total?
That would make sense. Probably.
You got your big four.
Mm-hmm.
Maul and Palpatine.
They
Dooku,
do like little
Vader
callbacks. Like yeah. Bane is referenced, but they don't really give any information about it.
But Bane is a canonical Sith Lord, so that's five.
Okay.
Yeah. Darth Plagueis, does he count? He's referenced.
Plagueis is
six. Okay.
Right?
And then there's like a the one that's referenced in the High Republic crawl, but he's only in like one episode, one comic so far. Anyway, so there's seven. There's got a couple of other Easter eggs, like Revan's been referenced, but only I think in like a cookbook or something stupid like that, right? So I would call him. What would you call that, Freddy? Like
Revan's
adjacently canon,
Rice Krispies,
kind of canon,
cookie crumbs.
That is like. I don't even know. What is cookbook canon on? Is that like...
that's not G-level, that's for sure.
That's not G-level. Definitely not G-level.
We need a big stamp, like a gavel that says, that's not G-level. whenever somebody says something ridiculous on Legends Look Back. Well, this entire episode is going to be ridiculous and freeform, and I can't wait for it. And I want to give a special thank you to our patrons who make this possible, those who have helped support the show and continue to do so. And, man, we've been wheeling and dealing behind the scenes because something huge hit the world of Utini Patreon. I want to encourage everybody to go check this out. Totally worth it. That is, if you guys check this out yet, the Living Force crew got together just like in the fall before we ever did the celebration thing. The first time Living Force hosts all went and met, they chronicled it and they made a documentary. And Nathan, our buddy, video editor, stitched the thing together.
Yeah.
It finally was released to the World Wide Web this week. And it is the Asheville documentary. What is it called? Friends of the Force, The Force and Friendship, Final Fantasy.
Final Fantasy Pikachu. Friendship in the Force.
G-level. Nailed it. G-level. So, a very huge thank you to our patrons. Special thank you this week to Ashley Ingalls, our new Alliance High Command member. Way to go. You get a G-level thumbs up. Congratulations. And also to Admiral Akbar 1983 for re-upping that annual subscription. Those annual subscriptions really go a long way for us to be able to say, like, all right, this person's along for the ride. They've signed the dotted line, and we can make some content and make it happen. So anyway, go on over there to the Patreon and check out that documentary. I got to say, it brought me to tears. I immediately messaged the Legends Look Back team and said, we got to get together, do like a retreat. I want Rick to teach me how to play Armada.
Mm.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Is that the one you like, Rick?
Oh, Armada? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Could you not tell by the grunt?
Mm.
That was the
same. Ooh, yeah.
All right, there's another that one that's similar. What is it called? X-Wing?
X-Wing, yeah.
What's the difference?
How much time? Do we have time for that?
Well, obviously, X-Wing follows on, starfighter combat. It's more like... It's the zoom in. What's that? Micro or macro? Macro. It's the macro level. Nope. Micro. Yeah. Micro. That's the one.
Basically, whereas you're on the ship level, right?
The ship level. The squadron level. The fighter level. The squadron level. Yes.
Rick's husband's name is Micro. What? I mean, Mike.
What?
No, I said Rick's husband. Emily's husband. Whoa. This just got weird. Emily's husband. I tried to make a joke.
So the I got Mike so confused. And the Mac and...
That was...
I'm out of practice. I missed the show.
Yeah.
Oh,
I said Rick's
that's
husband.
The reason.
Rick's face for our audio listeners just turned as orange as his shirt.
Yeah. Well, I was really confused. Like, did you know about that? But I'm just joking. Sorry. No. Anyway, Armada. Armada is fleet level combat. You know, you're the admiral of all the capital ships and all the squadrons. Ships. Yeah, plural.
And they're beautiful ships.
They are beautiful. Yes.
The detail. Yeah.
Just collecting the ships alone is worth it. I'll just show them off sometime. Yeah. But then X-Wing is...
I would 100% play Armada.
Yes!
Well, I'll bring all the videos.
Rick is, like, vibrating right now.
I love that game.
He's, like,
his camera is around. That's right.
Hold on. Let me thumbnail that.
If you want to shake around like Rick, go on over to patreon.com/utini. I don't know for sure if that's the right URL, but if you just type in these words into the Google, like I did today.
The Google.
Utini Patreon. You'll get it.
You could have used the cha-cha.
You throw it or into cha-cha. You throw those things in the cha-cha.
Cha-cha and, died in 2016, by the way. I looked that up.
S in the chat for cha-cha.
Yeah.
And you can
242
get access to that Living Force Asheville Friendship and the Force documentary. It is absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. And I might just have to rewatch it again tonight.
It's good stuff. Definitely
that
good stuff.
Great.
I actually FaceTime Corey.
If you have jokes about how what's that?
I FaceTimed Corey, and he's like, hold on. And then Eric got in the frame, and then Wes got in the frame. I was like, wait, are you with everybody?
But me, like, what is happening?
Why is Jerry
FaceTimed
not there? Why
Corey? I don't think I could handle that.
Yeah, it was an interesting little thing.
This is intense. For me, it's like if you've got to do something as desperate as FaceTime Corey, it means like the show is about to self-destruct. And there's like so many levels of people you message for help before you message Corey, the CEO. You know what I'm saying? But
well, most of the time he just ends up fixing everything anyway. So I feel like just going straight to the source is usually my go-to.
He came on one episode and he totally taught me how to redo our entire workflow, and I instantly forgot it. So right back to the way we used to do things. But you can hop on over there and get you a sneak peek at that documentary. Guys, man. Let's get into the show.
Yeah.
I want to spin that wheel. I want to ignite those red sabers. And I want to somebody choke me a little bit. I want to see a little bit of the Sith lightning. Right, let's get into the Sith Lord stuff.
Yes. Right? The darker control, the better. Dark side.
Alchemy. What do we got, Rick? Here's the way. Let's talk about the way this works first. All right, we've never done this before.
So this is based off of fantasy sports.
Explain it, Emily. Yes, please.
Yeah, so it's pretty common, but fantasy football is the most common one, where you draft a fantasy team that you are the manager of. So you want to pick what you deem to be the best players, and then throughout the season they get points, and then you win at the end. Whoever makes the best team wins. Obviously, we can't really play out our teams, but I feel like you could probably let us know whose team you think would win. I am very interested to know how much you think my team is going to win. By what margin? Because I'm pretty much going to crush this. I'm super hot.
We'll see about that.
Emily, time out.
Everybody's going to know. They'll know.
Real quick, what's your opinion, everybody, on fantasy sports? Here's mine. I don't want fantasy in my sports. I want sports in my sports.
Yep.
And when
you go to Star Wars for my fantasy.
That's right. I've got enough fantasy. When I want to watch sports.
Jared, you're hilarious. You're like, you don't believe in personalities. And like,
I don't believe in personality profiles. It's all pseudoscience.
You don't believe in humans.
That's right. I don't believe. No, it's all pseudoscience.
He doesn't even like people,
fantasy
okay?
Fantasy football is legit. It's a way for you to be like interactive with something that normally you just watch. Like,
here's
you can
be
a participant.
Be you go, woo, touchdown.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
See, I'm a hockey fan, so I don't yell touchdown. Mm. I do yell at the refs, but that's a different thing. Everyone does that.
Interactive.
Yeah. I will say that I only do fantasy hockey. I don't like fantasy football because I don't understand. Like, I understand football.
Are
but
you serious right now?
Yeah. I don't follow football teams that
is
well
really
that much.
Is there really a fantasy hockey?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Yes. I thought it was as easy as the football. It's easy, y'all. The football one is very easy. They tell you the points, and you just click draft on the highest number of points. It's very simple.
Yeah.
Fantasy hockey was like learning Mandarin. I had no idea what was going
on. It's great. It's great.
I was like, sure, we'll do this.
But playing fantasy hockey helped me really to appreciate other players and other teams, and it helped me understand the dynamics of good players, stuff like that.
I followed along with the Utini fantasy this year. I've never paid any attention. I'm not playing. I'm their classic old school sports fan. I cheer on my one team, and when that's over, I don't pay any more attention to sports the rest of the week until the next game. And then I just find out, hey, if somebody's injured or there's a big controversy, they're going to tell you. You go find out. But I followed along. It's really fun to see, you know, who's whooping up on who, and you know, you got your fun little rivalries, and it is kind of interesting. To
and
watch
the creative names.
Yeah, for sure. There's a lot.
I love it.
Real quick, Freddie, what's your opinion? You a thumbs up or a thumbs down on?
Whoa, Shoemake, whoa, Red. That was Mandarin.
Hey, wait. We'll talk later because I took a Mandarin class in high school.
Too busy learning actual languages.
I know.
To do fantasy sports.
You know, I don't even know the first thing about drafts, so
we're gonna do it right here.
I'm sorry. Am I the only one that does fantasy football?
Yeah.
We are three nerdy Star Wars guys.
See, like I just follow a different martial art, like more, you know, UFC thing. I can kind of see a draft there, I guess, but it's all like single player in a sense. So.
I was waiting for someone to be like,
this was a twist.
I thought drafts were like, which version? And like Freddy or someone would be like, I thought drafts were like craft beer or something.
Oh,
you know, and so
a bunch of drafts last week.
I mean, you know more about that.
Yeah. So.
Freddy is the draft king, if you will.
Draft king.
Well, congratulations to Emily and her. She is the queen of
I'm in two leagues and I placed second in my league last year.
Wow, nice.
I feel like,
yeah, I got some money. It was nice.
So, does that mean we have to give up our man cards now? How does this work?
I'll collect them after the episode.
Okay.
That's a. outdated.
We'll redistribute them to the best Sith Lord team.
What is that? What's the archaic gender stereotypes we're doing?
I know. This is a legend show.
Well,
what do you mean archaic gender stereotypes?
That's right. There's no such thing in legends. Okay. So I did, having never done fantasy sports, I invented some of my own rules tonight.
Oh, dear.
I am, however, going to tell them to you now instead of tell you at the end.
All right, time out.
However, don't let me forget, we do have a twist ending. There's a twist ending. Okay.
Twist.
What? Go ahead, Rick.
I'm a youth minister. You guys know that. And all of my guys, not a lot, all, but a lot are playing in a fantasy league together. And I had a whole bunch of drama because one of the guy who runs the league changed a bunch of rules. And so they were all angry at church at each other because someone changed the rules to their fantasy football league. And I was like, do you hear yourself right now, guys? Do you hear yourself? Like, it's going to be okay. But anyway.
It gets personal.
So
like, this is my team.
That being said, you better not change the rules on us, Jared.
Okay? I'm not changing the rules. All
right.
They don't make a ton of sense. So here we go.
Oh, dear.
First of all, we're going to spin the wheel and determine who goes in what order.
We got the wheel.
Then we're going to – here's the house rules. You have to choose at least one character from each category. Here are our categories. Are you ready?
I am so ready.
Film characters. Mm. Comics characters. And books characters. And I don't know why I said and because there's another. I didn't see it. I had to scroll. And I'm using my normal hand. What do you call the hand? Your dominant hand. Both hands are normal. I'm using my dominant hand to count. My other one is scrolling.
My strong hand.
Which is not the way
Have
I do it.
Have you seen his
hand? They don't look to be the same size. Can we have a size comparison? Oh my goodness, that hand is so okay.
Video games.
Oh, we're so off track. Yeah.
The fourth
category
is video games.
So it's video games, books, comics, and phone characters.
Correct.
Cool.
Don't think about it too hard. Some of the categories overlap.
They do.
So because of that, with film characters, we got the four Sith Lords. You can only choose. Everybody has to choose one from that category,
mm-hmm.
and you can only choose one. All right. So then,
it's like your quarterback.
Sure.
Or your.
Oh my gosh,
this is
going to be interesting.
What's the point of this team? What are they trying to accomplish? Like
that's the next rule, Freddy.
Oh dear.
Thank you for asking.
Oh no.
We get to create our own rules on what our teams are accomplishing.
Sith, I mean, I feel like obviously team. Galactic domination. Mm. Like, is that not the goal always?
That's a perfectly valid goal, but it's not the only goal.
Mm. Hashtag conquer the chaos. That's my goal.
Okay. Emily conquer is straight spitting facts tonight.
Yeah.
I was thinking like a sillier theme for my team. Like
it's Sith, man.
Like potentially
you want
a
silly.
Team.
Let's do like Jedi
team.
Academy
only
draft.
That would be great. We should do that. All right. All right. So here's what I was thinking. Like a team of only mask wearers, like hashtags stay safe or whatever we used to do 2 years ago. And now we don't care. Right.
Yeah.
So
do your part.
Hashtag mask up. That's my team.
Mask
right.
Up.
So that could be like, I'm only choosing mask wearers. So then you could potentially steal a mask wearer like Malgus or Malik, you know,
what we can steal.
No, what I'm saying is, like, you could know that.
Okay.
That would be strategy.
Okay.
Don't you play strategy games, Rick? Come on.
I do. That's not how the draft works.
Well, I go for the Sith Lords that are, like, masters of subterfuge and, like, deception.
That would be
versus,
perfect,
like, power.
Yeah.
You know?
So I want everybody
or
to, like,
Sith
declare.
Lords missing limbs.
Mm. I want everybody to declare, like, this is my theme, right?
Yeah.
You're not just willy-nilly choosing Sith Lords. Like, commit to the bit, right? So, you could go for team chemistry or lightsaber duelists or highest midichlorian count.
All right.
Or, so all of those are best at making like 4th of July fireworks, you know, with their lightning storms.
Yes.
So, anyway, you gotta choose a theme and a team name that goes with. Are we ready? Let's spin that wheel.
All right, let's spin it.
What we got?
First up, our number one first round pick goes to.
I love that you put a football field in the background. That's hilarious.
All right.
Yes.
Number one overall pick. And we're doing a snake draft, right? So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So what we're going to go ahead and do is determine the order before. Oh, that was sad. They watched me just
first.
Get sandwiched out like
you
that.
Got...
That animation was brutal.
You're gone.
But you get
you're
first
gone.
Pick, though.
Yeah, so there's your consolation.
I never once for a second anticipated that I would have first pick, and now I'm like sweating this.
All right. Second pick goes to... Boo,
his. It is literally right on the line.
Well, you
and
know what?
They gave it to me.
Yeah.
Poor Frick.
What gentleman?
Emily has picked two.
All right, now watch. Man. Consolation is to watch Emily's name disappear.
Yeah.
All right, 50-50, Freddie. How you feeling?
Wait.
It's all right.
You ready for this?
Do it.
Should be. No all more, right. No less.
Right. Yeah. I'm it's getting dizzy. Today. It's like a altimeter, like, what's it called? The. Hey!
Okay. The good news, Freddie, is you got the swing pick.
Not necessarily. Let's see. Aww. So, Freddie, you get number four. And
by default.
Yeah. Four of.
Well done.
Hey, I like third. Third's a good place in the second round, too. So, this is strategic.
Second is great because nobody wants first pick. There's too much pressure. Yeah. So, how are you feeling, Jared?
Getting
what's
third.
What's your goal?
I could just coaster this thing and make a team.
Getting third place, Rick.
Auto draft. That's what Freddy's
in the Sith Lords draft is like, it's pretty sad because their whole thing is like two.
Yeah, that's fair.
And you got third. All right, Rocky in the chat says that last pick is best because you get two in a row. So
that's
from
true.
A certain point of view, see what I did there, Star Wars?
Uh-huh.
From a certain point of view, Freddy won.
Yep.
Mm.
I'm stalling for time while I think about what the theme of my
team
is going to be.
Oh, that's a good idea. I should get a shot clock.
Oh, that's a good idea. So think about that. Emily, what's your thing? What you thinking? I'm thinking
okay,
ladies.
So my,
I could do like all ladies.
I mean, that's a choice. You could definitely do that. I am choosing Conquer the Chaos. I'm going to stick with that. I kind of like it. It's like the Galactic Core is overrated. Like I want the unknown space. Like, give me Outer Rim, Sith, like ones that are focused on like being like in the shadows, conquering lesser known worlds. I like that.
Okay. All right. I'm thinking you could even go era. You could get mostly like, I almost said Old Testament. I meant like old school, old Republic sort of time period. Most of them are anyway. But
those are like history and like, I don't want to give away my strategy.
Yeah.
Just like,
you
know,
what
you pick first.
Where are you leaning, Freddie? What you thinking?
You know, I keep thinking like, if I were to be a Sith, what kind of Sith would I want to be?
Yeah.
Hmm.
And I'm going to definitely, I think, recruit based off of that. The kind of Sith that I'd hang out with, you know, we would just, you know, go wipe a whole race off of a planet just for fun or something. I don't know. We'll see.
That's an important thing
we'll
to
see.
You.
We'll see.
Yes. So genocide? That's your
genocide.
That's yikes, man.
You know, it's like, hey guys, you want to just go wreck the planets tonight?
Oh my gosh. So it's Frida Nad would be probably your like number one, right?
We'll see. We'll see.
Okay.
Still trying to work this thing out. We'll see what you guys pick here, and I'm just gonna coast through this thing.
So here's the issue. The one that I want the most in terms of like, I absolutely have one Sith out of all the rest of these that is most important to me that they are on my team. The issue there is I don't think any of the three of y'all are going to lead with that pick.
Hmm.
Hold on. Are we?
I might can come back around and get that in the second round.
Oh, now I want to spoil it. Do you want to look at the,
yeah, I'm ready to see the grid if you are. Let's show the listeners. We spent some time. I'm just hit my microphone. I'm so excited about this. We worked hard, and by that I mean like a good 15 minutes on this grid. All right, we've got these are our choices. Ready to
That's
go through?
A lot of dark side.
We've got like... Darth Talon, Darth Krayt, Naked Palps, Plagueis Maul, one of the ones from Tales of the Jedi. Which one is no crash? No, hold on. Frida Nad? Nope, that's not Frida Nad. It's Naga Sado, right? Ulit Keldrama. Who's the next one there?
Darth Hanna?
Yeah. I want to see if Emily would say it. You got Lord Khan. Going back to the left side. This starts with a V. Nope.
Is that Tenebris?
Yep. Tenebris, Lumaya, Kydus, Revan, Nihilus, Malak, Sion, Malgus. These are a lot of made-up words I'm saying right now.
Yep.
Treya, Vitiate, Starkiller, Dooku, Palpatine, Vader, and Nagasato. No, Frieden and Nad. I'm getting them confused. Yeah. I'm Googling it.
Huh. There's a lot of fury and red and purple and lots of dark. So this is like a little bit difficult to tell visually, but you have the smooth, buttery sounds of our voices to guide you through this draft.
Yeah,
that's right. Absolutely. All right. I think I am ready for my first
pick. All right. Hold on 1 second.
You working on a timer?
Rick, what was your goal?
It's undisclosed because I don't know yet because I'll see what's available. So,
yeah, Rick, same plan.
Jared, are you ready?
Just go wing it.
On the clock, go.
Ready? Okay, you know, you will notice that we have two Palpatines on here. I wanted to get like two of a bunch of these different characters. So, like, regular Maul and then Spider Legs Maul. But, you know, it was really adding up to be way too many Sith Lords really quickly. But we did have to have Palps and Naked Palps because, as far as I'm concerned, two different characters.
Yeah,
you know, Dark Empire Palpatine. He's like
his own
vibe, right?
Naked
but
Palps
I didn't
is a
put
clown.
The naked one. I put Naked Palps in the high cloak with the high collar, because you don't know NSFW and all that. My first pick out the draft is none other than. Let me ask it to you this way: Have you ever heard the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wives? I just said wives.
Yeah.
Darth Plagueis the Wives.
Plagueis has 10 wives.
Yeah, Darth Plagueis, a polygamist. One of the reasons why he was such a great Sith. All right. So.
All right, time's up. The first round pick goes to Emily. No. The timer has expired. You missed your draft pick.
I said it.
See, Jared, let me tell you how fantasy works. Whenever you're drafting on the app, if you don't put your pick in time, you lose that pick.
Everybody heard me say Plagueis.
You did say Plagueis before the time was up. You did.
Man.
It was just a very roundabout way of saying it.
The timer was going, and I felt like I needed to get right down to the bottom, okay?
All right, fine.
Off the board. First pick.
Did you procrastinate a lot in college?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Cool. All right, is it my turn?
Can I explain why?
Yes.
And if anyone wants to debate if that was the correct first pick of the draft or not, I feel like that now would be a good time to do so.
I'm feeling like
Darth Plagueis is great with the midichlorians. I don't know where I'm going with this.
I can't tell from these little thumbnails. Is this the Darth Plagueis picture you have? Okay.
Yeah. You can tell by his big head.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Moon.
You gotta slip that.
Immune.
Yeah.
Moon.
Yeah, that's right. Moon. You gotta swallow a little bit.
Yeah,
Plagueis the Wise. I mean, the dude was a goat, except that he did
beautiful. All right.
No, he wasn't a goat. He was immune. We've been over this.
So first pick. Now, I feel like Palpatine did him dirty, you know, dying in his sleep or drunk or whatever he was. I feel like he deserved better. There you go. First pick. What y'all think?
It's a good pick. Solid pick.
Good pick.
He's got the techno beast thing,
money.
You know.
Got one of the best books ever written.
Yeah.
That's true. It's a good backstory.
He's got money. What a great.
He's a banker, you know. He's kind of got connections, friends in high places.
He possibly created Anakin. Who knows?
Yeah.
Right, next pick. Who's up next?
That would be Emily. Let me get your timer ready.
You're probably not going to need it.
Also, you know, Plague is pretty good for, like, choosing Palpatine. That's kind of a big one.
Yeah.
That's true.
All right, here you go.
Judgment.
And you're on the clock.
Okay, well, it's definitely going to be Darth Vader, 100%. Mm. And I'll use the rest of my time to tell you why. Basically, he and Thrawn were, like, biffles, like, way back in the day. And I feel like he would know more about the chaos than most of the others.
Mm.
Plus, I mean... You gotta love him. And he's my daughter's favorite character. So, like, I've got personal ties to Vader.
Mm. Nice.
That is
a solid pick.
Rebuttal. He destroys the Sith.
I mean,
chaos, man.
Of course,
chaos.
Jared.
Rebuttal. He was always a Jedi the entire time.
I mean, okay.
Chaos.
Okay.
Embrace it.
Here's the funny thing, Emily, was I was making the grid. As I was downloading the images for all these characters, I got to the very bottom of my list, and I was like, why am I coming up one short? Who'd I forget? Only the most notorious of all time. Darth Vader was not on my list.
All right.
Great. You know, in Legends, let's talk, highlight their Legends histories a little bit. Obviously, Plagueis, you've got one notorious, notable. Wow, it really froze on the worst possible image in my face. you got one basic, you know, tome with Plagueis. With Vader, though, what do you think is like the best Legends Vader story? Could be the Ghost Prison was good. We enjoyed that.
Ghost Prison was great. I loved Ghost Prison. Especially just chucks the dude over the edge of Coruscant at the end. Like, what
spoiler
a bad
alert!
Move.
Oh, come on.
I mean, everybody here has read it. If you haven't, then
Revenge
like
of the Sith,
you don't know who.
I don't know if we can count Revenge of the Sith as a Legends book. Rise of Darth Vader, Dark Lord, that one's good too.
So if I recall, one memory I have from, and I can't remember if it's that book, The Rise of Darth Vader. I think it is. It goes through how uncomfortable it is to be in that suit, and you know how he always is itching and he can't do anything about it, and it's, you know, he's trying to heal himself, and you know, even going to the bathroom is a whole thing in itself.
Very visceral, definitely very visceral. Good pick, Emily. It's, you know, despite the fact that he's pretty bad at being a Sith.
I think I'm just gonna really like rely on the fact that none of you know how to do fantasy teams, and your lack of enthusiasm for my choice is not reflective of the actual validity of my choices.
Hey, I'm not responding only because I'm desperately trying to figure out who I'm gonna pick next. So that's my lack of response.
At this game.
Yeah.
Ready. All right.
I mean,
just like Vader,
you know,
he's
I'm
more
a
like squeeze
competitive.
Throat, cutthroat, but you see what
it's
I mean.
It's okay.
All right. Rick, you are up next.
Alrighty.
Don't you give yourself a longer timer just because you're pressing the buttons over there.
Yeah.
2 minutes.
Got a lot of buttons to press. That's the thing. All right, here we go. I'm on the clock, and I'm going to pick somebody really cool who's has a name and a face and some skin.
Don't forget we're picking Sith Lords, not hockey players.
Oh, right. Yes. Number one pick. See, I need to like read an article and listen to a podcast and get like a spreadsheet before I do this. Like that's how I draft and like
I gave you the list 3 days ago, Rick.
Oh man, I don't have time. All right. I'm gonna panic and oh boy. This is a big deal. This is round one.
Y'all are going to kill me.
All right.
What are you going to pick?
All right, let's see. I had a plan, but out of the plan. Oh, man.
She wrecked your plan when she chose Vader, didn't she?
Shoot. No, I had a plan, but now I'm switching it up. And I'm going to go with Palpatine.
Ugliest Sith Lord.
Palpatine. Yep.
All right.
Palpatine. Which one?
The OG Palpatine.
That's right, because you took Naked Palps.
Yes. Fair. Yes.
I
mean,
no, I didn't.
You did?
I took Plagueis.
That's right.
You just projected onto me. Thank you.
I mean, was I wrong? It's probably going to be your number two.
Where is Palps?
Freddy doesn't get him.
Do we have a picture of Palps?
Yeah.
I mean,
he's the wrinkly one.
I feel like we're pretty familiar.
Oh yeah, there he is. There he is. Yeah.
Got a hood.
I couldn't find him. Ew.
That is a headshot right there. Just glowing, sallow skin.
Sallow. Wow. What a vocabulary word. All right, Rick. Any reason why?
Yes. My reasoning is he is the baddest. He's the one who had it happen, right? Like, he actually was in control of the galaxy for a short amount of time. He ruled the galaxy, at least the known galaxy. You're not counting the unknown regions or, you know, stuff like that. So he did it. He saw a vision. He followed it through. He killed a lot of people to make it happen. He had some really cool force techniques. He was right under the noses of the Jedi. And he had the ability to just, like, rub it in their face and then kill them all and manipulate and twist people. He's the Sithiest of the Sith. So
Sithiest.
I feel like on sports talk shows, they would say, like, was it this team's win or that team's loss? I'm going to ask you, was Palpatine's, you know, victory over the Jedi really Palpatine's win or, like, the Jedi's loss? Wasn't it kind of just like they were blinded by their own arrogance and more than it was Palpatine being good at hiding himself?
I mean, I feel like he was, he like lived next to the Jedi Temple. I feel like that's pretty legit. Like, how do you live in constant shadow, like hiding in plain sight?
No, it's a great point, Emily. I just wanted to throw some shade on Rick.
hey, thanks. You know, he created a war for fun. You know, like, it had purposes, but, like, seriously, he was playing both sides. It was, you know, so, like, so evil.
He created a war for fun.
That was...
Yeah.
Just playing with them.
Yeah.
Chessboard. He would be good at Armada.
He would be. He would. Actually, right. You can play as him. Like, he can be your commander, which that's... Yeah, okay. Sorry.
So, I almost put 3 Palpatines in the draft.
And that's another thing. This is a unique character that is so important. Even he has 2 appearances in our draft. So, come on.
I almost put Monkey Palpatine in our draft. Freddy, you know what
that's
I'm talking about?
That's not a thing.
We're talking
Monkey
about the,
Palpatine.
The original Palpatine, which was, I think, a monkey's face, or what was it? Monkey's eyes?
So, Emily, in the original cut of The Empire Strikes Back, before the special editions.
You're kidding.
Vader, you know, he's got his helmet, and then he goes, and there's the big hologram of Palpatine. Vader gets on his knees, and he's like, "What is thy bidding, my master?" The big Palpatine face. Before Ian McDiarmid, you know, they cast him for Return of the Jedi, and then they photoshopped his face back into the cut. The original Palpatine. I'm losing my voice. Help me out, Freddy.
Yeah, the original Palpatine was basically, if you search it, original Palpatine. You're going to see the most hideous looking face.
It was a
How
woman
would you describe it, Emily?
With monkey eyes.
Yes.
Original Palpatine. A woman with monkey eyes?
It was a woman. Oh. And then they put monkey eyes up in there. That was, so monkey Palpatine almost made the list, but I had to cut some.
Yeah.
Shout out to monkey Palpatine. There's also monkey Leia, but that's a different story. All right, Emily. Rick. Who is it? The other one.
Freddy.
You have the 4th pick. And the 5th pick.
Ready, go.
You're up.
All right. Yeah, so I'm going to go with Darth Krayt.
No!
Oh.
No! I knew it! No!
You played it wrong, Jared.
Way to lose that first round pick. How does that feel?
Let's see. Wait, who was your first pick? Oh, or Plagueis. Okay. Why were you trying to go for Krayt?
I love Darth Krayt.
Yeah.
Dope.
Yeah, so Freddy, why did you pick him?
Well, first of all, his name is Darth Krayt, revered as Dragon of the Sith. And I'm trying to build a powerful group here, and I feel like I need Dragon of the Sith on my team, as well as, Ashurad Het. We see he was born on Tatooine, almost the inverse of Luke. Right, went to the dark side, and pretty powerful man. I mean, he
survived the purge.
He survived the purge. If I'm not mistaken, did he destroy the new Republic or the new Jedi Order, or what was that story? It's been
a
while.
There's a lot. Yeah.
Yeah. He.
I've got a guide about him on the site. You can read everything you want to know about him. He's an amazing
he's
character.
Fantastic.
But
let's see,
he's beat by a Skywalker who doesn't want to be a Jedi and doesn't give a crap about any Jedi business and does drugs.
See, that's why, though. Sometimes the people that just coast through life, they just, you know, they're sitting there and boom, stabs one of the most powerful people in the world or in the galaxy at the time. He ruled the galaxy with an iron fist.
I can't believe you chose the pick that I wanted the most, but I didn't go with for my first pick. Ah.
I mean, Ashurad Het.
That is,
you know,
hilarious.
Darth Krayt is—he's using, you know, that armor he's got there is pretty awesome. That's a plus.
He
got some protection.
The greatest EU villain.
Yeah.
I mean, the Dragon of the Sith. What? Like, he's armored. Ready.
It was Cade, right? Cade that got. I mean, Cade is also kind of your bounty hunter with intense force sensitivity, so, you know, Cade, I'd accept that. If anyone was gonna kill me, I'd be down for Cade.
What a great quote, Freddy. What a great quote. All right, I think I ruined your 5th pick, so we can start the timer over for that one. I got overexcited and crushed. Honestly, destroyed. I might as well not draft anything else tonight.
All right, so this is round two officially. Freddy, who you got?
All right, round two, I'm going to go with – this one's tough. I really want to take this person because I know a lot of people are going to, and I'm trying to build a team of intensity here. I'm going to go with Revan.
Dang it!
I knew it!
Everybody wanted Revan.
I love Revan. I mean his, you know, let's see. It's been a long time since I've read his story, but to go from Jedi to Sith, and then to be in stasis. Was he in stasis for how long? I don't recall. It's been a long time. And then his wife saves him. And first of all, the story of him finding his mask. You know, we never truly see who Revan is, and he's in this Mandalorian battle, looks down, picks it up, puts it on.
That's a great
He really
moment.
Becomes a different person at that point. The Revanists. But I definitely think having Revan on the team with Darth Krayt, you know, the problem with all of this is that they're all Sith. They're all going to want to topple each other. So let's keep an imaginary barrier. You've got Krayt and Revan. That's a pretty powerful team already.
Counterpoint. Revan is a better Jedi than he is a Sith.
Agreed.
We're not doing a wimpy Jedi.
Yeah, why not Bane?
Here. Well, see, I thought about that. I thought about Bane. He's definitely on the list, but there's others I'd like on my team.
Wait, Rick, do we have a Bane picture? We don't, do we?
I thought we did.
He's supposed to be in the draft. He's on my
also,
list.
Also, I'm going for guys with masks right now.
Well, that was my okay.
Just right now.
You took my whole theme. It's all gone now.
I thought your theme was chaos.
See, that's me coming in at number four.
A wild card. You know, Vader, Jedi, Sith, I don't know. Like, Revan, Jedi, Sith, I don't know. You don't know what they're going to do.
That's good. Chaotic.
I took two picks. Number four, right, dangerous down here.
You're up next, Emily.
It's dangerous at the bottom.
No. It's my turn.
Yeah, that's Rick next. Thank goodness.
Brian,
more time.
Go ahead.
Yep. Okay. So, Bane.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, who's your? You've got Palps and Bane.
Ooh. Palps and Bane. Take that. Literally, the guy who made the rule of two. How about that?
Yeah. So that's pretty cool.
Seriously, I'm winning this draft right now. Okay. Just gonna put it out there. So. Do we have a picture of Bane? I don't think we do. Do we?
How about this? No, I forgot to upload one because we've already got 100 on the site, and I thought, oh, I'll just copy it over from one folder into another, and then I didn't. So. Yeah.
It's all good.
How about this, Rick? Bane defeats more Sith than any Sith ever.
Ooh,
Therefore, the worst Sith.
Oh, no, he's the best Sith, the most powerful.
Best.
He had the clearest vision among the Sith of his time. The only one with true vision.
But I do have a question, though.
Mm-hmm.
Are you choosing Bane with obelisks or without?
With the bugs or without the bugs?
I'm sorry, I asked Rick.
Do you want Naked Bane or Beetle Bane?
Beetle Bane!
Beetle
I
Bane.
Love that.
Beetle Bane.
I'm like afraid to say Beetle Bane three times, you know, out loud or something. Yeah. Oh, man. All right, I don't know. I guess I'll go with Beetle Bane. Beetle Bane's cool.
Yeah.
Virtually indestructible.
I mean,
hot dog Beetle Boba Bane Fett. Has a mask.
Beetle Bane.
That's true.
Got a helmet.
That's true.
All right,
good
pick.
Emily.
Honestly, your two picks are looking really solid for sure.
Yes, I know, but thank you. All right, Emily.
Okay.
Round two, pick three.
Don't
go.
Forget, you've got to pick a film character. Emily has.
I did.
Go ahead. Yep, move along. Move along.
No. Y'all are really, really throwing a wrench in my strategy over here. So you took Bane. And you took Revan, so like, who is even left? So I'm gonna go with Darth. I think you'll know what I'm gonna say. Any guesses?
Hannah.
Dang it. Yeah. Oh, Darth Xana. Thank you very much. I feel like y'all are like just putting. They put Hannah in the notes because I made that mistake once. Yes, I'm going with Xana. And yeah. I feel like I need a sorceress, somebody like kind of like twist minds, because I think her like Sith sorcery is the coolest. And yeah.
She got the dreads.
I feel like you can do a lot with that. This curly blonde hair, but it looks like dreads.
Mm-hmm.
I almost put the original Bane cover, the original Rule of Two, Xana, in the images, but you got the cool one instead of the one that looks like it was designed in the PlayStation 1. Good pick. Definitely, you know, debatable that she could even be better than Bane. We don't know for sure. It's open-ended, right?
Honestly,
it's a little bit open-ended. It's less open-ended than I remember it. That's a little
I think
That's fair.
Yeah. I like that pick. Good job. That was going to be one of my picks. I need to make a wish list.
Because you guys keep taking my stuff.
I know. I need to like start making notes over here, you know?
Yeah. I'm going to do it right now.
Okay, good picks. All right. It is now my turn, and I'm looking at the list, and I'm feeling a little bit like, ah, y'all got some really good ones, and now I've got to – hey, all these are fun, but now I'm thinking, like, the most powerful Sith that's left, in my opinion, isn't one that I necessarily like a lot or, like, have a strong, visceral, emotional attachment to, but then I've got the ones that I do have a strong emotional attachment to that are not necessarily – like the greatest Sith, but I also want to stick to my theme, but the theme can be flexible. You know, why not change it up a little bit? I chose Plagueis. Oh, aha. Now I remember my original theme, which leads me back to my next pick, which is Naked Palps.
Ah!
Yeah, Dark Empire Palpatine. He came back from the dead. I mean, the Sith's whole thing is defeating death and prolonging life. And he did it with a ship full of slimy, pickled corpses. And they have smooth parts. And ooh, also Dracula capes. And this is one of them. And so are you. So
so let's all pick Garson.
That's right. So that's my next pick. Rick, you are now up. We're going to have to go a little bit quicker through round three.
No. Six. It's your turn again, isn't it?
It's me.
What? Wait. I have a swing pick.
Yeah.
Okay. Wasn't prepared for this. Malak is my next because Malak also has a vat full of clones aboard the Starforge. Also, cool mask, Malak.
So you're going for like quantity over quality. Just clones.
Malak has a very strong design, mm-hmm. and he defeated Revan the first time.
Okay.
And ruled the galaxy. And also the Starforge. He was on that. And he stole Revan's girl.
Mm-hmm.
Boom. Huh. Mic drop.
He did.
Huh. Yeah. Both in the video game and in person.
We saw him steal his girl completely in front of us, and we were shocked.
It's one of the greatest moments of my entire life, Freddy.
It was.
we were waiting in line to meet the Boba Fett, Daniel Logan, and the other one, Tamira Morrison. And while we were waiting in line, there was a cosplayer of Revan looking sad, very worn out from the day, his mask off, a few people behind him. Is a very buff, ripped, very with it. I mean, this guy was legit. We had a great chat with him. I loved him. Malak cosplayer and his wife or partner dressed as Bastila. Malak got his arm over Bastila. Revan is like a teenage boy, a few people up, just kind of like, ugh.
Tired.
Just dad. Yeah. It was legendary. Okay, Malak is my next pick. Very much did the good pickled vat cloning technique very well. That's the way I beat Malak when I play the game, is I run from him with reckless abandon as fast as possible, and you slash the cloning tanks, and then you lob grenades over your shoulder at Malak. Never actually cross blades with Malak. That's the key, because if you do, he will destroy you.
Good to know.
Also, his mask is not very COVID proof.
Mm.
The nose is just hanging out there for everybody.
Mm.
Who we got next?
Emily is up.
All right. So for my next pick, I have the father. I'm going for the son. Yes.
So good.
Except I don't think he's actually a clone, but the Scooby-Doo Luke. From from Dark Empire.
Oh, nice.
I mean, so if there was like angst personified, it has to be Scooby-Doo Luke. And like the fact that Palps wanted him so badly and like just so quickly gave over a lot of trust. I mean, the power, the raw power, Leia knew it. They all knew it. I'm going for the father-son duo. Let chaos reign.
Ooh,
that is
okay.
Very strong, Emily. I'm like over here, like grinning ear to ear.
Is there a picture of him?
So no, there's not.
Okay,
I'm so impressed with you
for choosing a comic character.
For choosing a character from Dark Empire, Scooby-Doo Luke. I thought for sure I was gonna have to pick that one.
Hmm.
Like a last pick, or like
somewhere along the line.
Hmm. Nope.
Very good. I'm impressed.
Third pick.
Also, hyperspace wormholes. They're good at that one. He does that whole force projection technique where Leia thinks that he left with her. And then he was like, yeah, sorry, I'm for real back over there with Palpatine.
Luke just doing that. Like, he's the only one that does that. He's like, I'm here. No, I'm not.
Like, wow.
Yeah.
I've secretly been in this other place the entire time.
This is one of the greatest comments in the history of Legends Look Back. In the chat, Skooma Joe says, Legend? I can't even say it.
Legend has it that Luke still has the black collar in his closet, but Mara won't let him wear it.
It's so real. I've got a shirt like that that I bought when I was on my international program. It's a purple and orange long sleeve button up, and my wife has never once let me wear it.
We've
been married 10 years. That's right. Very good. Very good. Round of applause. Congratulations. Skumadro wins the draft tonight. Game's over. All right.
Yeah.
That was Emily's pick. Frick is up next. I just called you Frick.
Again.
<Sorry. laughs> I've called him Frick before, too.
Y'all are best friends. Yeah.
Yep.
What's your name?
Here we go. All right. So this is
Don't forget, you have to pick a film character.
I have.
Who?
Palpatine.
Palpy.
Okay. I haven't. Okay, great.
You're the only one.
No, there's
no. There's... Yeah, you and Freddy. I picked mine.
Don't leave me with Dooku, Freddy. Don't do it, man.
All right, so I've picked. Who have I picked? I picked Palpatine, and I've picked Bane. Okay, so I've got my film character. I've got my book character. So I'm going to go with my comic character now. And Team No Grace is proud to draft to the team Sith Lord
8-7.
Freedon Nadd.
Wait a minute. You said his name like you definitely know who he is.
Definitely know who he is. And didn't have to look it up on the
wood. Nadd now.
Yep.
No shame in that. There's
Let me just say, like, I feel like Siths have the worst names. They're the hardest to pronounce.
It's yeah, weird about true. The name Freedon Nadd.
Yep. So, do you guys want to know my theme?
Yes.
Sure.
Hold on, I gotta find.
Only if you want me to spoil it.
You're not gonna have a chance because I get the. It's Freddy who can spoil it. But so this is him, right?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah,
That's the spirit of Freedon Nadd who haunts
right.
Ulic and Exar Kun.
Okay. So he was a human.
Drury Lane.
He was a human, right?
Yes.
Yeah. This is the most Sith thing I can do.
Gavin 4, right?
But my theme for my team is angry white dudes. there you have it.
Can't pick Darth Talon.
Yeah.
Angry white dudes. That's phenomenal. Oh my god. Now I know you can't pick Lumaya or the bird girl Vergeer.
Yep.
All right. So I know who some safe picks are now.
Yep.
Gonna show your hand.
I know. I just wanted to keep the show exciting. So Freddy, you better not ruin it for me.
Well, let's see here. So I go after this one, right?
Yes, you have two picks in a row.
Good, good, good.
Don't do it, Fred. Don't do it.
I'm picking, let's see here. I've got Darth Krayt, which I stole from Jared. Ooh, maybe that should be the Sithy thing. I just steal things from all of you.
That would be the most Sith thing to do.
And you know what? I'm going to steal another one from Jared. I'm going to pick Darth Maul.
I got the worst.
But you know what? I wanted to pick Darth Maul at the very beginning.
Yeah, I almost did.
Because I'm going for like brute force, really, really martial talent. But also, you know, I've got Darth Krayt, who I feel like can control the situation a bit. Because Maul, he's like a ball of energy. Maul's the kind of guy you send to a prison to basically assassinate every single person in that prison, right? And I feel like I need a Maul on my team.
Wampas.
There you go.
Doesn't he kill a Wampa?
Sure.
Probably. And Revan, we all know Revan is incredibly talented in, you know, every martial art. Mm-hmm. I would say, and I like, you know, part of the things that I like about the team so far, it's like, I guess a lot of force and will, you know, like Revan is he's very strong willed when he's on a path, whether it's light or dark. Maul is not somebody you can torture and break. I mean, you can cut his legs off and he's going to roam a planet. He's going to come back and he's going to rule a gang. You know, very, very tough to get rid of. Kind of like a fly. Just pesky, annoying, assassinating everything. Mm. And of course, Darth Krayt, who... yeah, or cat. Darth Krayt, he was, you know, dragon... What was it? Sith? It's Dragon of the Sith. Incredibly talented. You know, a fighter, strategist, etc. So, yeah. I'm going for right now, I guess.
Maul would have fit my theme too, man. Dooku don't fit my theme. Dooku get his head chopped off.
Try to make him fit your theme.
Hey, Dooku was my alternate for my angry white Sith dudes. So
I'll trade you Dooku for literally anyone else.
Yeah,
arthritis.
I'm not gonna trade Palpatine for Dooku.
No. I'll trade Dooku for your last pick. Let's see. We'll wait. I don't know. I made the rules. There's like literally two rules, and one of them is you have to have a film character.
And I have a film character. Oh yeah, yeah.
No,
up to you. Okay,
but
yeah,
if
yeah.
I trade him, then I wouldn't. And I would break one of my literal only two rules, which is a very Sith thing to do. They make that rule of two and then they break it all the time. They break
all
that rule
the
of
time.
Two. Mm-mm. Yeah. Can't yeah, thank it. You for getting Maul off the screen. He was staring laser beams into my soul.
Yes.
I was legitimately petrified. Okay, Rick.
Nope, Freddy.
You get another one.
Okay, Lightning round. I have not picked a books character at all yet, but I really feel like I want to pump my Sith team up with some legacy blood, if you will.
Uh-oh.
You know where I'm going with this one, Jared?
No.
Going with
previous
solo Darth. Cadus, I guess. Cadus.
Yeah.
Darth
I would
Cadus.
Say Kytus.
Kytus.
Kytus. Saidus. Whatever works.
Potato.
I haven't written an audiobook yet, so
yeah.
It's not official until I hear Mark Thompson say it.
those were his first books, his first audiobooks.
Yeah. I haven't heard him yet. I'm excited to, but
they're abridged.
I do
not
like his story.
Abridged. A little bit.
Yeah. So I feel like getting some like Skywalker bloodline in the mix would help me with the luck factor, you know?
No, Rick, not that one.
Oh, no. This one, right?
There you go.
Yeah. There you go.
That's right. I had to clear
and
last time.
Who had Vader?
Emily.
I did.
I'm pretty sure Jason had the same traits as Vader, so he might find a weakness.
Counterpoint.
Hmm.
Kytus is a punk.
He is. Yeah. Yep.
He's a
yeah.
punk. Who else
That's
did you want?
Point.
You know what? You're gonna get there. Sorry.
Okay. Who's
Am
that
I
next?
Done? Am I done with my?
You're done. You've got your team.
There you go.
Oh, we're down to last pick.
This is it.
All right. This is it. Last
All right.
choice.
I feel good. I feel good. I feel real good. I don't know much about my next pick, but I feel good. So for round four, pick two, I'm going to pick a video game character because I have to, right? Do we have to, right? All four categories?
Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Yeah, and, I'm stuck with Duke.
I'm going to go to a game I've not played, to be honest with you. And it's going to be from Knights of the Old Republic to the Sith Lords. It's going to be the Lord of Pain himself.
Dang it.
Darth Sion.
That's who I wanted next.
Ah! Because
oh my goodness.
I was looking through who was left, and this guy looks like the angriest, oldest white dude I could find. And he so he made the team.
Literally white from like old. Decay. Like it is. Like,
yeah.
Those on the audio podcast, Darth Sion is akin to a dry desert floor that hasn't seen rain in about 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
AKA like my hands mummy, when I live in like, New England.
White.
I love on, I'm not on Wikipedia, I'm on another site right now, but apparently his hobbies are hunting Jedi and inflicting pain on others. So,
I mean,
yeah. He definitely is part of the team. Part of the team. So I have got four old crusty white dudes. And
he waves his newspaper yeah. at kids when they
I hope
cross
you feel good about that.
I really All don't. Right. I really don't. I'm going to need a shower next, but, you know, at least I'm consistent.
I was playing KOTOR 2 on the Switch when it released earlier this year. And I was waiting. I'm now waiting on the added additional restored content.
Ooh, yeah.
Pretty
oh,
soon. Yeah. And Sion is one of the scariest dudes who has ever happened in the entire Star Wars universe. When he shows up on the Harbinger at the Telos mining station, it is so friggin' scary. He is terrifying.
I really need to play that game.
It's great. Nihilus, it's great.
Nihilus and Sion were both on the council together. Is that
kind of like a 1-2 punch? Yeah.
Yeah. And Nihilus was, I think he was like the Lord of Hunger or something like that. Crazy.
That's how I'm starting to feel this time of night. All right. Emily, you've got your last pick.
I know.
Y'all are all beating me, I feel like.
We are.
I made this game and I'm not happy with how I'm doing.
It's because you've never been on fantasy before. Like, you don't know how it works.
Freddy's not done fantasy and he stole all my picks. All right.
Number four, I told you he's going to cruise through it.
Okay, see, this is the point in the draft when you really have to start examining team dynamics, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I have my video game character left, and I was just, you know, browsing, and like I was like, oh, Darth Starkiller sounds great. Only problem is, who kills Darth Starkiller?
He's just Starkiller.
I don't think he even gets the Darth name.
Yeah,
right?
He doesn't, but...
All right, well, Vader kills him, and he's on my team. So, like, I can't draft that dude.
But he's powerful. He's powerful.
Depends on how you play the game. You can beat Vader.
No. See, I think I need something that can just – I need somebody who can just, like, control the environment, right? Because I've got mind. I've got lightsabers. I need environment. I'm going with Nihilus.
Ooh, I love Nihilus.
Nihilus is a great pick.
Yeah.
Literally kills entire planets.
Yeah.
When conquering the Outer Rim. Yeah?
I wanted Nihilus, but I had Revan because I knew you wanted Revan.
I know. You suck.
Nihilus.
You could trade
these. He's going to be my next pick, right? I would trade for sure.
Yeah, we'll trade for – I'll get Nihilus. You get Revan, and then Jared can get Palps and
– Nope.
He's stuck with Dooku, though. Nobody wants Dooku.
Oh, bless his heart. Am I right? Here's the thing about Nihilus. Person behind me at the tattoo pavilion was getting a Nihilus tattoo.
No way.
Yeah. And as soon as they started, I said, after they'd already started getting it inked on them, I said, hot take, Nihilus sucks. Like, worst Sith Lord ever. While this person's getting it inked onto their body, worst Sith Lord ever. I said, I've always felt like Nihilus was a little overrated, don't you think? And she was like, no. She was tattooed on her. And she's like, the whole thing is like nihilism, you know.
Nihil, yeah.
Right, Nihil. It's like, there is no point. Life is meaningless. sort of.
I'm hungry.
Also, in the game, Nihilists don't say nothing. No personality. Mm. It's just like this void.
Mysterious.
Darkness. And it's a great character
that's
design.
Terrifying.
But like, there's no depth of dimension. It's just black hole of a person. Mm.
Yes. And that's who you draft at the end. You got your star players. And now you're like, okay, who's left? Who can fill the gaps?
I like Nihilus. Good choice.
I will say, sure. Out of the remaining video game characters, a pretty good one. Pretty good, good one to choose.
Thank
I was
you.
Thinking about Vitiate, like the Old Republic Emperor, for being, you know, the one who can like maintain eternal life. That's what I was shooting for. Was like the characters who cheat death, which would have made Maul a great pick. Freddy or Sion, who literally is like come back from the dead and is this walking corpse. But instead, I'm stuck with Dooku. Dooku is my last pick. I have Dooku.
Can you explain why Dooku's on your team?
He's now Sith Lightning me because I'm not happy with taking him on my team. Sparkle fingers.
I feel like this is the sign for Dooku. He's just hey,
spirit fingers.
So how does Dooku work in your team?
Yeah, what let us see. Add what dynamic?
What dynamic?
He gets his head chopped off.
Do it
immediately.
he's a Sith Lord for what, 2 years?
You can use him as a pawn then. You know his head's gonna get chopped off, so use him as a setup.
I feel like y'all really, really, really shafted me with Dooku.
Well, you were going for quantity over quality, right? So like Dooku has a whole bunch of like assassins that aren't like
two
technically Sith.
His
They're
head
like...
and his body.
Hey, same with Maul.
I would like Dooku's fingers. I choose Dooku's fingers, his arthritic fingers. Mm. Dooku
for their lightning qualities.
Is actually well fleshed out in a book soon to be released. Here we go, salvaging him. Hmm. Soon to be released as part of the Essential Legends collection, Yoda Dark Rendezvous is a very good Dooku story. So it really adds depth of dimension in the Legends universe for Sparkle Fingers himself, Count Dooku. That's right. Also, the curved lightsaber is really, really dope.
Yeah, it's elegant.
So the thing about Dooku, which, let's be honest, let's go into the real universe for a sec and talk about Christopher Lee. Like, he was an incredible human, right? He, I don't even know his entire story, but every time you read like a Wikipedia entry, you're like, this guy lived through all this. He
a
did
legend,
all this
for sure, absolutely a legend,
absolute legend. And he's, you know, maybe he killed some Nazi general, and you know, it's a crazy story. And then he's just there smoking his like cigar, hanging out in the gentleman's club that they have in England with, I forget who. I heard.
I don't
story.
Know
it
all
was
those
crazy.
Details, man. I might
yeah, it's
him.
Crazy, man. It's
cool.
Crazy.
All right, so awesome. Can everybody go around and like say their full team?
I don't know. Can we?
Yes. I have Plagueis. Naked Palps, a third one, and also Dooku. My
third
one was Malak. That's right. Malak and his nose, and Dooku and his head. And that's my team. Hi, so happy with that team.
You started out strong.
A great idea.
Downhill. Yeah.
Well, you didn't get your, like, your real number one pick.
Or my... number two, or my
number
three,
two.
Or my number four. So here we are.
I feel like your mistake was in like you drafted your film character too late in the game.
Yes, yes.
And you didn't end. Go for the one you really
see,
wanted to.
I started
I can see that now in hindsight.
You strategize by the pool, right? Like whatever has the smallest pool, you pick first. And so
yep.
My pool is infested with mosquitoes because my pump is broken.
Oh. Cool.
And so is right. Your draft picks. Okay.
throw some catfish and I'll take it.
Emily,
you're that right up.
Emily, yeah. Go ahead.
All
right. I forgot.
So my final team is Vader, Xana, Scooby-Doo, Luke, and Nihilus. I've got that father-son combo with Vader and Scooby-Doo, Luke. And then I've got a sorceress and an annihilator. And I feel like that's a pretty good mashup.
Yeah, but what's the theme? What's the theme?
The theme
tactical
is...
genius.
Yeah, I don't know. I was going for like more of like a
chaos.
Like
it's very chaotic.
Yeah, it's chaotic. Yeah.
It's a very chaotic team.
Yeah, all Vader's right. my quarterback.
Classic
chaos. And then, you
know,
his wide receiver, Scooby-Doo Luke, for sure.
Yeah,
and then we've
catch
got
the ball.
Nihilus is my defense, just sucking life out of planets right and left. Mm. And then we got Xana just like twisting minds. So like nobody
Ooh.
Knows what's up. Great defense.
That is true. That is true. Good defense for sure. That is good.
Special team.
Am I up?
Cool. Go ahead,
I think
Rick.
So.
All right. My final team. I'll go from video games, Darth Sion, then in books. This little guy named Darth Bane, and comics, Freedon Nad, way to go, and film characters, the Emperor himself, Darth Palpatine. Well, not Darth Palpatine. What's his name? Darth Sidious.
Darth
Palpatine.
Palpatine.
I said it and immediately was like, no, that's not right. Darth Sidious Palpatine.
Darth Palpy.
All right, that's all I got.
There's
I'm going to
so
stop talking.
Darth Naked.
Yeah, but let's. Hey, I've got a theme. I'm consistent. I got a bunch of angry white dudes, and I'm not happy about it because I'm really uncomfortable even saying that as much as I have tonight.
You've really
but
committed to your theme.
I did. Thank you.
Good job.
Thank
At
you.
At first, Very I wanted clear. People who wore masks, and then y'all messed that one up. And then I wanted unlimited, like the midichlorians, you know, eternal life. And you messed that one up. So that's yeah. my team. That's what
we,
I've got. All
we right. can pretend that Dooku has like a mask collection that he wears when he's by, in his castle by himself. You know?
Who knows what he's going to do in that castle.
Yeah.
Probably has like medieval
this
helmets.
One makes me happy.
Yeah. And Freddy, your team.
All right. So we've got Maul, Darth Maul.
Who?
Darth Crate. Maul and Crate. And let's see. We've got from the
team.
Darth Cadus, or how do you say it, Jared?
Titus.
There's that. And then, of course, Revan. I believe they're all pretty strong. You've got Darth Crate, who, in my
team.
Opinion, is kind of the, I would say, a good strategist. He's been around for a while. He's pretty powerful himself. So he's not afraid to fight if he needs to. Maul, who is just a pure energy of dark side rage and power. Number one assassin. If you need any generals hit, you know, weak points found, Maul can do it. Revan, and what I'm gonna say about Revan, and he's gonna be like your ultimate right hand man. Anybody who anything that needs to be done, you can always. I would trust Revan to get it done efficiently. And then let's see, who did I have? Did I get everybody? Darth Cadus? Oh, he's just a punk that needs to be. You know, he's got some pretty powerful people above him. And he has potential himself, but he's a punk still. So, you know, I just he'll figure it out. He's got
That's
solo.
A strong
he's got
team.
The Skywalker
might,
blood.
That might be my favorite of our four. That might
honestly
be.
It was too because that was like two of my four picks. So that was fun.
Freddy is his team is called Team Steal Your Girl.
Team Steal Your Jedi Sith.
Right. Very good. Very good. All right. So here's some of the characters that didn't make the cut, though we thought about considering for the draft. Some great legends Sith who at least deserve a brief shout out. Let's go around the horn here and each take a turn with one of these. Ready? Ajunta Paul. He was in the Knights of the Old Republic comic. He was also one of the very first Sith Lords ever. So shout out to Ajunta Paul.
Yeah, next we've got Tulak Horde, who was also in KOTOR, I believe. Anything
one of those,
interesting
one of those
there?
Tombs you go hunting? It's got the calf hounds hanging out inside.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds calf right. Hounds. Emily?
Marka Ragnos?
Yeah, Marka Ragnos. didn't quite
from
make
Tales of the Jedi and KOTOR as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Darth Ndedu.
Darth, all right, this one I'm glad that it came back around to me. One that didn't quite make the cut, though I almost put on the list. I've always called him Darth Brandon.
Yes.
That's what I saw.
Yes. That's why I was just snickering, like Darth Brandon.
It's looking like it's looking like his name is Darth Bandon. And I described him in the notes as Malak's punk apprentice. And he is exactly that. He's like not quite on the same level as, you know, two of the most enduring Sith Lords of all time, Malak and Revan. And then way down the list is Darth Bandon.
He's definitely a Brandon. Definitely a Brandon.
Very much a Brandon. Shout out to all of our Brandon listeners. We love you.
Interesting. Freddy? Yeah, I actually don't know these two.
Onion? This was autocorrect.
Onion. Damien? I was like, what is this, man?
Onion Darth, and Damien. Darth,
ketchup and pickles.
Onion and
Orion.
Veggie Tales.
I was like, what is Onion? Who's Darth Onion? Why didn't we put them on our team?
You like to talk to the dark side.
All right, I'm looking up the knight.
Oh, where?
The knight errant Sith. There's
is my lightsaber.
There's like these four Sith in knight errant. And then like the two brothers are pretty interesting. Damien and who's the other one? Odian? It's not. Yeah, Odian sounds right. I'm looking it up.
Definitely not Onion.
Definitely not Onion.
Darth Onion.
It is. It's
Onion.
Odian. I think it's Odian.
Yeah, it sounds right to me.
Right. His younger brother is Damien. Damien.
Yeah. There we go. Odian. Thank you, autocorrect. Sorry about that, Freddy. Emily,
you're really called
Darth
a
Onion. But I want to get to know this one a little bit more.
Man.
He kind of looks like an onion. He's bald.
Well, he's now Darth Onion, so there's that.
I bet John Jackson Miller was like, I'm going to make this guy look like an onion, but then change his name just a little.
Imagine the autocorrect in his Word document when he was writing that manuscript.
Oh, that's funny.
Onion dust.
All right. The next pick that didn't quite make it, from Path of Destruction, we've got Cordis, Kopej, and Cassim.
Yeah.
I mean, they were a nice little bullying bunch.
Yeah.
Didn't quite make it, but, you know.
Great
you can't all be
nonetheless. That's
the
right.
top picks.
Yep. From that same trilogy, next up is Darth Cognis. Didn't make the cut.
You know, I like Cognis. I feel like in the story, you really see how evil and dark a Sith is by just toying around with like things that you know hurt them for fun. You know, that was pretty terrifying.
Mm-hmm.
Just not in the story a whole lot. Just kind of like tacked on at the end. So
yeah,
you kind of have to fill in the gaps. I wonder if she's in any like ancillary material, reference guides or anything. I ought to look it up. From the Legacy Comics, there's literally dozens of Sith Lords that didn't quite make the cut. Most notably of them being Darth Weirlock, who looks like, what's the species that looks like a Twi'lek but has the horns? Togruta?
Togruta.
Yeah, Togruta.
Yeah.
Well, he's red. The red Togruta with big horns. Huh. And is hanging out with Darth Krayt and up to no good. Who else?
Yeah, next on the list we have Scourge, who is actually, I want to say, maybe one of the only pure blood Sith on here. Is that true?
Yeah, on the list at least.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah. So Scourge is... he's in SWTOR, of course, and I want to say he's like the personal enforcer for the Emperor at the time, at least from what I remember.
Yeah.
Pretty powerful dude. You know, pure blood Sith. I don't even know. Do you know when the pure blood were decimated? Because, you know, being a pure blood Sith was a very important thing for them.
Not off
everybody
top of my
else
head,
was kind of secondary.
Definitely an Old Republic thing. Mm-hmm. He's also, you know, in the Revan book, but. It's fun. I played the SWTOR game last year, and he's like a companion you can have on your team. So you can carry him around with you, and then if you make any light side choices whatsoever, he's standing in the background with his arms crossed, and then the text says, Lord Scourge disapproves. Very fun.
Put him in your pocket, hang out with Scourge.
And lastly, Vectivus, who is, what is he, like Plagueis' secret apprentice, the Biff?
Yeah.
Who then... Plagueis has to go and find and kick his butt.
Bites the dust.
Yeah. And here for our, almost forgot about our big surprise. There's one last Sith Lord that we did not put in the draft.
Ooh.
Though definitely would have been first pick of the draft had we. And it was just so clearly the first pick of the draft if he had been in the draft. Therefore, we had reserved him for last place. Just as an honorary mention. And that is none other than. Can I get a drum roll, please?
sound like a happy cat, Emily.
I don't know. This is why I don't make sound effects, y'all.
Darth Tumnus.
To Freddy.
Darth Tumnus
is number one pick of the draft, honorarily, in all of our hearts.
Tum.
So let us know, everybody in the chat, who in the Utini, what are those called? YouTube comments and the Legends Look by Discord channel. Let us know on Twitter, all those good places, who you think has the best team out of the four of us. I definitely know it's not me, but somebody's got to give me a, you know, throw me a bone, right? That at least give me one vote, please. One vote.
Okay,
please.
Hold on. Before we go, here's my last Legends team. Hot Dog Boba Fett, Beetle Bane, Naked Palps. Who are we missing?
Pickled Snoke.
Oh, my God.
So good. Oh, my gosh.
Best
so
team
good.
Ever.
Very good. This is fun. I like the draft. Now I know why Eric likes him so much. Shout out to our buddy Eric over on the Living Forest for loving doing these drafts. And to also all the fantasy sports people out there. Way to go. Mixing some dragons and magic into your sports. Just breaking the mold. Congratulations.
I get it. Dragons.
Jared, you
fantasy.
Scheduled this. This was your choice.
I was a listener. Somebody
you're
asked
complaining.
For it.
You're just pouting because you got Dooku, and that's unfair. It's unfair to the rest of us.
The worst.
Would you guys like some random ASMR Chick-fil-A drinking?
Yes.
And that does it for this week's episode of Legends Look Back. Huge shout out to our buddies over at the Star Wars Archives. They're on Patreon. Trevor and Jose are about to celebrate their 50th episode. Do want to give everybody a quick plug for what is coming down the pipe over there. Just over a week from now, we have two Sundays away on September 25th. They are releasing their 50th episode. Very excited. And I will say, episode 49 is their sand episode. Joxie's been asking for it for months, if not years, and finally they did it. They did a podcast episode all about sand in Star Wars, and it does not disappoint. It's basically an entire episode of Trevor becoming unhinged, and it is totally worth your time. So even the smallest of Patreon dollars gets you access to those episodes, and so definitely want to plug those over there. In the meantime, if you want to follow along with what we are reading, we've got an episode coming up in a couple of weeks. The next roundtable for Legends Look Back will be Darth Maul Shadowhunter. And oh my goodness, am I excited to talk about it. I've got like 10 pages of notes. And then I stored them in a Jedi holocron. And then a Nemoidian ran away with it. And I've got to go find them in the underlevels of Coruscant. It's a whole thing. But in the meantime,
as they rebuild it.
You can go pick up your own copy of Darth Maul Shadowhunter by Michael Reeves. Check out the audiobook read by Sam Witwer. It'll be totally worth your time. That does it for this week. Thank you for joining us for Legends Look Back. Thank you to our incredible patrons for your support. We love making the show, and are glad you're along for the ride. Special thank you to our Jedi High Council, Brian Dooley, Earl Q, Patrick Ortiz, and Carl Sander. Help me out, Freddy. I'm losing my voice.
All right. And our Alliance High Command, Ashley Ingalls, Elizabeth Cloutier, and Sally and Chris Eilerson.
Somebody give me one of those Plagueis breath masks.
Not sure if we finished the first one.
Yeah.
But to say it again,
yeah,
a special thank you. Okay, cool. We're good there.
That's right. Remember to subscribe to the channel, leave us a review in your podcast platform of choice. And if you'd like your thoughts around the show, you can find our contact information in the description below. We are also on Twitter at Legends Look Back. And if you're looking to buy some of these books, such as the great books we talked about in this episode featuring all these bad boys, the Sith Lords, you can go on over to utini.com, look up your book on Utini, click the Amazon link in the profile, and after you've done so, read the book, loved it, hated it, whatever, leave us a review and let us know what you think. And remember to keep the Utini fan code and be a force for positivity in the fandom. May the force be with you.